Tell me what you think. 336-1320 is the Kello hotline.
Greg Belfridge makes a living using his words.
So I welcome your thoughts on this. Is this going to really set the country sideways?
But recently, those words have been harder to find.
Greg@kelloradio.com. It takes more work. Already getting some of your reaction to this.
To do my show now than it did prior to the stroke. So I would be lying to you if I said, no, I'm exactly the same person I was before this. No, it's changed me. I have a harder time finding words.
So do you then, Curtis, do you think?
Last July, Belfridge was in the middle of his three-hour radio show when he felt something was off.
I had numbness on the whole left side of my face and my arm. I could talk. I didn't notice any slurring. Others did. I didn't. But I knew something wasn't right.
He rushed to the emergency room where he found out one of his arteries in his brain was completely blocked and another was partially blocked.
I still remember this day having a conversation with Greg in the patient room. So he had presented to us with symptoms of a stroke. They were fairly mild, fortunately, at that time. But Greg was what I call hanging by a thread. And that's because the area where he was having the stroke only had blood supply by one main artery with no other collateral vessels coming in. So he was hanging by that little thread of flow.
I started doing talk in 1997.
Belfridge immediately received a stent to open up the passage in his brain. He has since made adjustments to his everyday life in getting more exercise and eating better.
Don't be afraid of those changes. Make them, and make them boldly.
Nearly a year later, he can joke about it now.
So if you're just joining us this morning.
And I had joked for years that, you know, I'd get angry about things, and I would jokingly said, I'm going to have a stroke on the air someday, and I never really intended to.
But Belfridge understands the gravity of the situation and how that day on air could have been his last.
I just have been felt very fortunate to be alive, to be able to share my story. And it's one of the reasons I'm so glad to talk to you is because, and I've told my listeners on my show, you know, about my stroke. And don't, if you have suffered any of the signs or you know somebody who suffered any of these signs, take it seriously.
Thank you so much, my friend, for letting me join you this morning.
With this Avera Medical Minute, I'm Andrea Anderson.